Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. It's with great pleasure that I have accepted the invitation extended to me by the chairman of the Conference Committee of the Institute for Cultural Diplomacy, Mr. Mark Donfield, to address such a distinguished audience. I consider it's a great honor, as a great honor and privilege, and I would like to thank him for providing me this opportunity. I would like to thank him for providing me, and on this occasion to congratulate the Institute of Cultural Diplomacy and the Ayman Foundation for the organization of this conference and their initiative to bring forward the importance of cultural diplomacy as a tool of promote and strengthen international relations. Culture and diplomacy have a long and lasting line of coexistence and collaboration. They are based on dialogue and represent the need of people and nations to understand each other. The major political, social, and technological changes which occurred during the second half of the 20th century have inevitably influenced the field of diplomacy as well. During the last decades, the so-called classical diplomacy has evolved. It has been enriched with new functions and practices. Culture has thus become an essential tool of contemporary diplomacy and an important aspect of international relations. If I were requested to define cultural diplomacy, I would say that it is a set of policies and practices used by states for establishing and promoting international relations through the channels of culture. Cultural diplomacy attempts to produce understanding that goes beyond stereotyped images and to mold perceptions in a favorable way. Quite often, the promotion of foreign relations through cultural activities aims at improving or strengthening bilateral or multilateral relations when other channels of communication, more traditional, do not suffice or are not open. In some cases, a strong cultural presence can help a state outbalance its political or economic weakness and enhance its image on a worldwide stage. As a general principle, it can be sustained that cultural exchanges can contribute to establishment of mutual trust between states, which can lead in the long run to a better mutual understanding and avoidance of political crises and conflicts. Hence, from the times of Alexander the Great and the Pax Romana to our century, component and inseparable part of the diplomacy of a state, cultural diplomacy has been. Nowadays, the huge majority of states acknowledge and appreciate the role of cultural diplomacy and use it as a major tool of foreign policy. Nonetheless, only very few of them have managed to master effective, coherent, and diversified and lasting policies in this field, since that requires considerable resources, well-designed policies, adequate and well-trained personnel, and local expertise. It is therefore the privilege of few states, mainly of the greater economic powers, to develop and sustain an ambitious cultural diplomacy. Usually, the activities of cultural diplomacy are carried out by special cultural institutes, which, along with the teaching of the language, try to acquaint the foreign societies with the way of life and other forms of culture of the country that represent, such as music, drama, literature, art, etc. It is therefore easily understandable that cultural diplomacy is intricately linked with public diplomacy, their ultimate goal being the best possible presentation of the image of a state and, through it, the achievement of the state's national endeavors, strategic interests, and long-term policies. Ladies and gentlemen, in this new world which emerged from the ashes of the Second World War and the fall to a large extent of barriers and walls, where new technology provides for a fast and direct electronic communication, ideas and information circulate and are exchanged in an impressive quantity and speed. This new era of globalization encompasses all lands and people. It is hard for any state and any ethnic group to keep aside and remain uninvolved. Cultural diplomacy should therefore not be considered and used as a means for entrenching one's national culture through a process of overindulging and inconsiderate self-assertion, nor as a process for imposing the supremacy of the culture over the others, but as a means for building bridges of communication and mutual understanding between different societies. Common cultural characteristics, the use of a common language or languages belonging to the same linguistic group, common faith, common identity, common history, traditions, customs, can create close ties between nations and lead to close economic and strategic cooperation. Thus, intercultural dialogue has proven to be a major element of cohesion in modern societies. Under certain circumstances, it can be used as an instrument of soft policy and prove very helpful to the consolidation of world peace and stability. Being a country with particularly rich cultural heritage, Greece acknowledged quite early the huge potential of cultural diplomacy and has tried to use it along the others more traditional forms of diplomacy as political and military cooperation, trade and economic cooperation, humanitarian and development aid. The instruments used for the cultural diplomacy are primarily the country's diplomatic missions and the foundations of Greek civilization whose agencies function in some European cities. For the elaboration and the implementation of the cultural programs, there is a close cooperation between ministries of foreign affairs, culture, and education. A great asset for the country has undoubtedly been the fact that it is the birthplace of the Greco-Roman civilization and of the ideals of democracy, democratic governance, and dialogue, which have become the milestones of the modern democratic societies and the foundations of the European Union. The Greek language and cultural heritage from one side and the modern Greek artistic and cultural production from the other side, strongly interconnected as the two inseparable facets of the Hellenic cultural presence over the centuries, are the pillars of our cultural diplomacy. The main factors that have to large extent determined the cultural diplomacy of Greece and its main components are the following. The geopolitical position of the country. Lying at the crossroads of three continents, Europe, Asia, and Africa, Greece has been since ancient times a point of contact, a hub of economic and cultural exchanges between peoples and states within a broader geographical region, comprising the lands around the Mediterranean Sea, Europe, Asia Minor, North Africa, the region of Black Sea, and the Arab world. The close contacts between Greeks and other ethnic groups, initially through trade and then through the establishment of Greek colonies, go back to the second millennium before Christ. These contacts have led to a better mutual understanding and the establishment of many economic and cultural ties who have survived the conflicts and the tremendous political changes that occurred in this sensitive geographical area over the centuries. These ties are still vivid in the conscience of the local populations and help bringing out the common historical and cultural experiences and building bridges of communication. Second, the Greek language. Although nowadays modern Greek is spoken by less than 20 million people, one should not forget that Greek was the language of communication, the lingua franca, of the biggest part of the world for over 15 centuries in antiquity and in the Middle Ages. It is a language used without interruption from the 3rd millennium BC up to the 21st century. It is characterized by continuity and particularly rich written tradition. It is a language used by the first and most renowned epic poet of the world, Homer, to compose his Iliad and Odyssey. It is the language of the greatest philosophers, Plato and Aristotle, who have shaped and defined European thought and philosophy. It is the language of the greatest tragic writers, Aeschylus, Sophocles, and Euripides. It is the language of the fathers of the science of history, Herodotus and Thucydides, of medicine, Hippocrates, of science, Thales, Pythagoras, Archimedes, to name just only a few of them. It is also the language in which the New Testament was written, the foundation of Christian faith. We consider our language as one of the most determinant factors of our national identity, an element which leads us to self-knowledge and conscience of our cultural origin and heritage. The knowledge, ideas, and literary masterpieces which have been expressed and written in this language have shaped the European thought and civilization and have become a part of our common heritage. The Greek governments have therefore considered as their duty to support all efforts internationally made for the survival and, if possible, the foundation in universities and colleges of church department centers of ancient and modern Greek studies. This effort remains at the epicenter of our cultural diplomacy, although due to the serious economic and financial crisis that our country has faced during the last 5 years and the adoption of severe austerity measures, the budget for the financial support of these institutions has been considerably reduced, with the risk that some of them interrupt their activities. Furthermore, we support worldwide all initiatives aiming at the use of new technologies for teaching of the Greek language to non-natives, such as the program Odysseus of the Department of Greek Studies of the University Simon Fraser at Vancouver, Canada, which serves as a method for teaching the Greek language in many universities in North America and China, or the program for the safeguard of the Greek language through the creation of an electronic dictionary of ancient Greek, the Thesaurus of Greek Language of the University of California, Irvine, to mention only a few of them. Third, the Greek art and civilization. The rich cultural and spiritual heritage of Greece has shaped the Western civilization. Let us not forget that Greek-Roman civilization is acknowledged as one of the pillars of the European unification at the point of reference for the definition of the European identity. The Greek artistic production over the centuries has been diverse and prolific. Greek artifacts, whether columns and parts of architectural monuments, or statues, or frescoes, or pottery, or armaments, or jewels, or religious relics and icons, or Byzantine manuscripts, or paintings and sculptures of the 19th and 20th centuries are exposed in the greatest museums of the world. They are the permanent ambassadors of the land, its people, and its culture, and guide foreign nationals and visitors to a better understanding and appreciation of Greece and its history. Besides plastic arts, Greek culture is well represented by its music, both classical and modern, drama, dances, and athletic competitions. through performances, world festivals, films, and athletic competition, it has gained international recognition. Let me make a special reference to some major Greek contributions to the world cultural heritage that Greece has tried to revive: the Delphic idea and the Olympic Trust. They both aim at the interruption of conflicts, at world peace and better mutual understanding. They have been embraced by scholars, intellectuals, and even politicians all over the world. The athletic competitions known with their Greek names, Olympic Games and Marathon, were born in Greece 2,500 years ago and have become the most prestigious international competitions of the modern times, since they have a unique moral dimension, being related to the idea of peace. These games have become vivid international cultural moments and are cherished by people all over the world. Fourth, the Greek diaspora. The Greek nationals and the people of Greek descent living outside the borders of the Hellenic Republic are estimated to approximately 7 million people. There is a Greek presence in nearly all countries of the world, but the strongest ones are found in Europe, North America, Australia, the countries which emerged from the former Soviet Union, and South Africa, that is the regions where the Greeks had a historical presence since the ancient times and the regions they emigrated to for economic or political reasons in the 19th and 20th century. The Greek diaspora plays a crucial role in promoting Greek language and culture abroad. The Greeks living abroad usually hold a prominent position in the local societies. They are skilled professionals, entrepreneurs, and businessmen, scientists, academics, journalists, sometimes even politicians. Through their cultural associations, where they often meet, their ties with members of their family living in Greece, their frequent trips to Greece for business, work, or holidays, they have preserved to a large extent the Greek culture, language, customs, and traditions, and the most important of all, the feeling that they belong to the Greek nation, their Greek identity. They have therefore become ambassadors of the Greek culture abroad, while at the same time, through their active presence in the local societies, the best representatives of their new homeland in Greece. In this way, a dense network of political contacts, economic and cultural exchanges between the Greek and the foreign societies has been established. The Greek government has been supporting these contacts of the Greek diaspora with Greece through various actions. Our aim is to establish an efficient and fruitful cooperation between the national center and the diaspora, taking into account the social, linguistic, and cultural particularities and needs of its members. Our most important concern has been to provide a high standard education to the children of the Greek diaspora to help them preserve the language of their ancestors and acquire a knowledge of the Greek culture. Depending upon the size of the Greek communities abroad and the number of the children, bilingual or trilingual schools have been established. In other cases, afternoon or Saturday morning classes have been organized with the aim to teach the Greek language to children who follow an academic curriculum in a non-Greek speaking school. In various countries, special Greek classes have been organized for adults who wish to learn Greek or to improve their knowledge of the language. These schools have been financed by the Greek state or with the assistance of the Greek communities or the Christian Orthodox Church. The implementation of this huge project requires an important number of teachers, teaching material and books that in majority of the cases are provided by the Greek state. Cultural trips to Greece are organized for the children of the Greek diaspora so that they might broaden their knowledge of the country of origin of their parents. Through the cooperation with the Greek communities abroad, musical performances art exhibitions and festivals are organized, which also contribute to the promotion of the Greek culture abroad. Fifth, the role of the Greek Orthodox churches. The common faith has been, over the centuries, a link, a channel of communication between the European nations of Southeastern and Northeastern Europe and the Christian Orthodox communities of the Middle East and Northern Africa. These links are based on common religious traditions and spiritualism of the Byzantine heritage. This common heritage has facilitated communication and helped to build close cultural and often political and strategic ties between the nations living in this geographical area. In our multicultural, globalized society, intracultural and intra-religious dialogue may serve as a precious instrument of preventive diplomacy to the prevention, avoidance, and the escalation of local, regional, and international crises. In this sense, it could act complementary to cultural diplomacy. So, ladies and gentlemen, in our time, culture, which is a factor that usually differentiates people, paradoxically, has proven to be the strongest channel of communication. In this modern, globalized, interdependent, and technologically advanced world, characterized by versatile social, political, and financial structures that they offer generate crises and conflicts, culture reveals itself as one of the most reliable means of contact and dialogue, provided that every nation respects the cultural identity of the others. Cultural diplomacy is undoubtedly a major component of foreign policy and international relations. Through the synergies of economic, public, and cultural diplomacy, a more efficient and productive foreign policy can be achieved. Thank you very much for your attention.